as big.
Okay, now that's better. That's better.
You too.
Yes, God,
you are ready to offer, and we will do that. We will offer a path to a much better future. It begins with an end to the aggression of your regime. And that's what the president was saying, that his only goal here was complete, verifiable.
Can I go this way, sir? We'll go this way. I'm tired.
I am too.
I know. It is tough this time of year. The days are so long.
Between 2017 and 2018, and the North Koreans made a first overture toward having a summit, and the president left with the idea. And in Singapore, in June of 2018, we're very proud of what took place today. I think our whole relationship with North Korea and the Korean Peninsula is going to be a very much different situation. People are going to be very impressed. People are going to be very happy. And we're going to take care of a very big and very dangerous problem for the world. And as the president said later, we fell in love. What came out of that?
Whoa!
Vaguely worded statement.
Where's Chloe?
Right there.
Chloe! Come on! Come on, Chloe. We're not going to choose without you.
Substantial progress, and of course there wasn't any, which led the president and chairman to meet again in February in Hanoi.
Bought a bunch of dust from these two.
What was supposed to be
which way?
You're going to pick the way.
That summit broke down.
She wants the little one.
You know what?
Yep.
That the United States would lift the most onerous sanctions on North Korea, and in return, the U.S. would simply get the dismantlement of a major nuclear area.
Girl, you're walking the trail.
It's the famed no man's land, very heavily mined, and the president said, why don't you come down and meet me just to say hello? That was an impromptu invitation by the president via Twitter, saying, I'm going to be in South Korea, I'm going to be near the border. Yes, and it's exactly what most diplomats would tell you you should never do. Never have an unstructured meeting with no real agenda and all that. Pyongyang.